your showcase.
Everyone has worked so hard to put on a great show for you guys, so I hope you guys enjoy. So for our first three actors, join me in performing Stand Up by Cynthia O'Viewer.
But first, to start us off strong, please give us your respect as members of the Fairfield Symphony perform the Negro National Anthem, Lift Every Voice and Sing. And we have Mr. Melvin Williams here to explain the beautiful, powerful history behind the song.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, Fairfield. We'll try it again. Good morning, Fairfield. Welcome to the Fairfield High School Black History Program. Before we begin, we want to take a moment of silence to recognize one of our former teachers, Mr. Perdue. He was not only a teacher at the school, but he was very much an active participant in the Black History Program. But this time, let us pause for a moment of silence. Thank you. I was asked by Mrs. Nance to, and when you get quiet, I'll be quiet. Thank you. I was asked by Mrs. Nance to provide a brief history of the song Lift Every Voice and Sing, which is a Negro national anthem that was created in 1900 by James Weldon Johnson. It was first performed at the birthday celebration President Abraham Lincoln. But before I do so, I want to share with you a brief story. About a couple weeks ago, I had a conversation with a buddy of mine who lives in Maryland, and he's also caregiving for his mother, who's 94 years old, and she's aging and in declining health. And he texted me, his mom was a teacher by profession, and he texted me a copy of her teacher certificate that she received on July 1st, 1951. That was just 71 years ago. And on her teaching certificate, it said, High School Teacher Certificate and Academic Subject, valid to teach in colored schools. Valid to teach in colored schools. So just 71 years ago, she could only teach to kids of color. And that's why this song, Lift Every Voice and Sing, from my perspective, it's so important because it speaks to the strife and the struggles and the separation that and the dark side of our country. But also, it provides us with motivation, and there's a message and there's meaning in this song. Three lines I want to uplift very quickly in the song. It says to sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Second one is, sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. And lastly, let us march on till victory is won. And it's my belief that regardless of where we are in our lives, juniors, that if we're going to be successful in life, we have to have faith, we have to have hope, and we need victory in order to win. So as you go forward, never give in, never quit, never throw in the towel, but always press forward until victory is won. Thank you. If you will, and are able, would you please stand? Thank you. Quietly, please.
Thank you.
performing a poem.
And then we have the Royal Borough African Fashion Show that will be showcasing traditional attire from Ghana, Nigeria, Senegal, Cameroon, and South Africa.
Hope you guys like it.
Thank you. But they want us to grow. We wanted to spread our wings like a bird, but all we got was Jim Crow. They say black is wrong, but I was told to always love my skin. I misunderstood the world I'm supposed to be in. We hung from trees like leaves, locked us in a room, and threw away the key. The room of oppression, which made me question, why didn't we just jump in the sea? Put us in the field, didn't want us to grow. Blood hit the soil like it was snow. Changed the way we look, put a hot comb to the throne. Conditions like this, how we supposed to grow? Black is wrong, but I was told to always love my skin. But I do understand this world I live in. I should be quiet, I should keep my emotions down. I'm a drug dealer, I'm a thug, was told to stop monkeying around. I am strong, I am proud, Black Lives Matter. I see black hearts shatter when another hits the ground. I have to be a leader, I have to do better. I'm a black woman, I matter.
Running in the fast lane.
the day.
So we have Brielle Shorter and Simula Osei performing our original poem.
And then we have our very own Tribe dance team performing for you guys.
Black student by myself, Smola of Science. Teachers will tell you, pay attention, because one day you're gonna need this in the future.
It's something so true and so mocking. Every morning the alarm clock goes off and my observations resume.
Like, hi, don't attempt to answer the problem on the board due to the fear of being wrong, because that's what's expected of me.
Just like the next woman who looks like me, she'll have her bosses, clients, and colleagues underestimate her intelligence.
They spit on my name as if it's left a bad taste in their mouth, mocking it with each sound and syllable.
I'm scared to even have my name read at graduation because of the fear that what is broadcasted will be unrecognizable.
It's realizing the same name can be printed on an application and be rejected because of the assumption that you're a problem.
Yep. Hearing your peers ridicule your culture and impersonate whatever warped perception of you that they have.
But somehow find a way to leave all the implications behind. I guess all they see is an aesthetic.
When you're yelling at a room full of your peers, and when the door is closed, you sit and wonder if all that came out was a whisper.
Or when you try to voice your pain, only for it to meet the ears of ignorance.
They will tell you to make your mark on the world.
In the same breath, to get over the bruises the world has made on you.
I ask myself, is this what my life has been reduced to?
Constantly questioning myself,
having to tiptoe around crack after crack just to be.
They'll teach you that your skin, your hair, your body is unacceptable.
They'll say your tears and rage make them uncomfortable and that you're less than.
They'll teach you that your culture and roots are theirs to rip out the ground if they so choose.
Even though I cry when I'm sad
and I bleed when I'm hurt, but that's never enough for me to materialize.
I've been left with the broken shards that were supposed to be blessed.
A plethora of notes that burn to the touch.
We have been taught to be afraid.
We have been taught to sit behind quietly. And I am teaching myself these things every day. Trust me, I've been paying attention to every detail.